Welcome to the YouTube channel of Hammers Gym. We are in front of the Hammers office in Breda. Next to me, Cor Hammers. Cor, in the last interview, we spoke about the Hammers Academy and the documentary about Ramon Deckers. Yeah. Your son, who is also the brother of Ramon Deckers, Nick Hammers, is owner of the Hammers Gym. He's continuing the Hammers Deckers dynasty. What are your thoughts about it?
Well, yeah, of course, I'm proud about it, you know, because I once started in 1984 with this Hammers style system gym. Actually, Ramon took it over, but then Ramon was not that inspired anymore, and he asked his brother Nick to do the gym. And in the end, Nick agreed, and I think he's doing well. So the legacy goes on, you know, the dynasty goes on. So I'm happy and proud that he's still doing this successful. I have to be honest, in the beginning, me and my wife, we thought he can better go into tennis or football, because yes, he was a very talented tennis player and a soccer player. And this is a tough world, the kickboxing world. So, but in the end, you know, he was actually born in this sport. So yeah, he popped up again in this sport like the rest of our family. And in the end now, I'm proud of it, of course, yeah.
If you speak about the Golden Glory team, most of the people don't know that you also had an MMA Golden Glory team. Can you give us some names of the old MMA Golden Glory team?
Yeah, actually, in the year 1999, Golden Glory started with MMA, you know, with fighters like Heath Herring and later Alistair Overeem, Valentine Overeem, Sergei Karitonov, Olaf Animo, Khalid Arab, Murat Chunkayev, all those guys were actually MMA fighters. And for me, that was new because I was coming from the kickboxing. The comment that I had in those days that I saw MMA and I said, you know, the striking part of MMA is so bad. It's really below C-class level. And that was true. So I was very helpful in getting those guys a better striking level. And I think now in general, if I look to MMA now, these days the striking is okay, and I developed a lot. But at the beginning it was nothing, you know. But I also have to study MMA, and I wasn't coming out. I had my judo background, but I was not really a grappler or a Brazilian jiu-jitsu. But the nice thing of our team by that time was that we had those qualities in our team. So we had a sambo wrestling with Heath Herring. We had a great wrestling guy with Murat Chunkayev. We had a Brazilian jiu-jitsu guy with Kazeka Munish. And we all joined together. And I was leading this team and determining the strategies and the training methods. And that became successful because our guys from Golden Glory MMA were by that time very successful in organizations like Pride and Dream and later UFC. I mean, Alistair went to the UFC, Heath Herring went to the UFC. So we started with MMA, and later, when Stefan Leko came in and Ramon was still there, we focused and returned back to kickboxing again. Then we became successful in K1 as well, like Alistair Overeem, turned into a great kickboxer and was the last K1 champion. So yeah, we have a big MMA history, and I'm happy that I learned the MMA sport as well. And I studied it and I made my strategy, so success as well.
How do you see the development of the MMA scene now in these days? And do you think MMA will blow kickboxing away in the future?
Yeah, I think MMA is still doing great, of course, and it also has a great history, and especially in America with the UFC, it's great marketing, and yeah, it's big over there. You know, there's also a background from wrestling, of course, in the United States. Will it blow kickboxing away? I think at the moment it is still bigger than kickboxing. But there is still an opportunity for kickboxing to become big as well. If I look back at to the old glory, and I've experienced our events in the United States, that were not events like with a big audience like the UFC, but there were always people from the U. UFC present there, a guy like Joe Rogan, very famous fighters from the UFC itself, and they always enjoyed, and they I see comments like, oh, this is amazing, this is great, because the striking part, what we did as Glory, was great, of course, and the people enjoyed. So I still think there is a great future, only we need to develop the right talent, the right athletes, and have a great marketing. So for me, still, of course, I believe in the future of kickboxing. But yeah, MMA will still be there, and I was there as well in MMA. So yeah, both can survive next to each other.
Talking about the UFC in the States, we saw photos from you and your son with Dana White at the UFC Performance Center. Is Hammer's Gym training MMA fighters as well? We saw, for example, Mark Diakiese in the Hammer's Gym preparing for his next fight.
Well, first of all, the Hammer's Gym is not, I'm not the owner of the Hammer's Gym anymore, I'm the founder, but my son is the owner, and the reason that we were by Dana White was not to discuss MMA fighters, but of course we have a great connection with Dana as his family and as a gym. And what I did when I saw that Nick was training Mark Diakiese, I spoke with Nick and I say, listen, if you look to the future, maybe it's interesting to pick this up again and also provide MMA training. And if you want, I mean, I have the experience and I have some time now, I want to help you. And I gave him some ideas for a great trainer to cooperate with him. And I think he is interested. So, yeah. Like I said, I will help them. I will tell Nick what I did in my time to be successful in MMA. And I think he's enthusiastic about it and that he will pick it up. So I think there is a future for MMA also in the Hammer's Gym.
What is exactly the connection between Hammer's family and Dana White? Can you explain us?
I designed a poster from Ramon Dekkers with my copyright from me and Ramon. And then we were approached by an artist who wanted to use that picture for the new performance center for the UFC. So I was surprised by that. I think what they need a poster from Ramon for. And then we invented that Dana White wanted to make like a tribute to Ramon, an conference room, a Ramon Dekkers conference room in the new performance center in Las Vegas. So actually that was an honorable thing. And I allowed that they use this picture for, and they made a very nice artwork for that. So that was actually the first connection between me and Dana White, and between Nikki and Carlo with Dana White. We were invited to come over. So we were looking at this conference room, and we were very honored, of course. And we asked Dana, yeah, why you do this? And he tell then the story that he thinks Ramon belongs to great athletes like Muhammad Ali, Ronda Rousey, Bruce Lee. They also have conference room. Also their family visited the new performance center over there. So that was actually the first connection that we had with him. And then the second time we were there, we were talking about a documentary from Ramon, and we interviewed Dana as well, why he did this for Ramon, and you will see that back in the documentary, what Dana White has to tell about that. So that's actually the connection between our family and Dana White and the UFC.
Soms wordt er iemand geboren en die is gewoon gemaakt voor die sport, weet je. Hetzelfde als een Muhammad Ali of zo, en dat is gewoon hij. Hij is gewoon Bruce Lee van kickboxen.
Kijk, Ramon Dekker was een god in taal.
Over 200 fights. He's an absolute legend.
Dat is een mooi hij.
Thank you, Cor. See you soon, and yeah, we stay tuned.
Yeah, thank you for being here.